reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. On the evening of the first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had established, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now, a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hand, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, it was easy for the disciples to believe in the Lord when they felt the magnanimity of his words, when they witnessed his healings, when they saw his miracles. But it was much harder for them to believe after he had been taken away to be killed. It was harder for them to believe when they realized that they also could be killed for having been his followers. Thomas doubted the resurrection because he had suffered a crisis of the crucifixion. His faith in God won, like the other especially chosen disciples who would later be called apostles, Peter, James, Andrew, Bartholomew, Simon, and all the rest. Thomas ran and hid. He was not to be found on Golgotha. He was too afraid to remember the promises of the Lord. His faith was restored again when he saw the Lord. To this point, Jesus told Thomas about the greater faith, the faith that he has called you and me to. The Lord looked at Thomas and then looked down the ages at us. Blessed are those who have not seen yet believe. When a crisis hits us, we all pray for deliverance. God, my deliverance comes, we feel that we have seen the Lord. This is all well and good. But how much greater is our faith when we hold on to the Lord, even when our prayers are not answered? Because blessed are those who have not seen yet. Last Sunday, we were called to believe in the resurrection. Our own faith in the resurrection is not based on experiencing the presence of the risen Lord, but on empty. When we feel empty, when we feel that the Lord is no longer in our lives, we have to recognize that more than ever, He is alive. He is among us. We should not feel bad about having crisis in faith. We should feel very human. We should also realize that our crisis can lead us to an even stronger faith. It challenges us, often strengthens us. Let me give you an example of this from everyday life. A 14-year-old child does something very wrong, something that could have resulted in harm for himself or herself, like go for a joy ride in the car and then get into an accident. Once caught, the teenager has to deal with that law and whatever reparation needed to be made. The teenager also has to go before his or her parents. The parents will most likely have their own punishment connected to the incident, such as, regardless of what the law says, you will not get your driving license until you are 17. But parents will still say to their teenager, I love you, despite your irresponsible behavior. When they do this, they demonstrate a fuller, deeper love of their child than before their love was tested by what the child did. And a higher plan for us to say to the Lord, I love you, and believe in you despite the times that I have been uncertain of you in my life. Demonstrates a deeper faith than we had before our faith was challenged. The young wife dies. The young man is devastated. He argues with God, even gets angry with God. How could you let this happen to her? He says in his grief, forgetting that God does not do bad things or cause bad things, but cries with us in our crisis, just as He cried with Martha and Mary when Lazarus died. In time, after the initial shock and upset, the young man recognizes that God is present in bad times as well as in good times, and then chooses to believe. His faith is now based not just on his experience of the good, but also on his choice of God during crisis. The crisis, while not caused by God, led him to a deeper faith and persecute ourselves, doubting is part of being human. The person who does not react with anger at the time of tragedy might be a saint, but most likely is a person who really never had a high quality of love. The person who recognizes that God was certainly there even at the time of anger is a person whose faith has grown. We pray today that we might all have a mature faith, able to grow through Christ. We pray today that we might all be included in the praise of the Lord. Blessed are those who have not seen but believe. On this 8th day of Easter, we also celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday. It's a day when the floodgates of mercy are opened wide and God lavishes us with more than we could ever hope for. Divine Mercy Sunday has been celebrated for years and years as a private devotion, but in the year 2000, Pope St. John Paul II, who himself was an extraordinary instrument of God's mercy, put this feast on the Church's official calendar as he raised Sister Faustina to sainthood. St. Faustina was a member of the Congregation of Sisters of Our Lady of Mercy in Krakow. She died in 1938. She came from a simple and poor family of farmers, had only 3 years of simple education, and performed the humblest of tasks in her convent. But she also was a mystic who was privileged to have many private revelations from our Lord, which she recorded in her Diary of Divine Mercy. She writes of her experience on February 22nd, 1931. In the evening when I was in my cell, I became aware of the Lord Jesus, clothed in a white garment. One hand was raised in blessing, the other was touched the garment at the breast. Through the opening of the garment at the breast, there came forth two large rays, one red and the other pale. In silence and gaze eternity at the Lord, my soul was overwhelmed with fear, but also with great joy. After a while, Jesus said to me, "Paint an image according to the pattern you see," with the inscription, "Jesus, I trust in you." My friends, as we celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday, intensely reflect upon the abundance of this gift that God wishes to pour forth upon us. There's no limit to how much we are loved by our God of perfect mercy. And today, on this, the 8th day of Easter, we should especially be aware of the fact that the floodgates of heaven are open to us to an unimaginable degree. Turn your eyes.